It is not only the duty of central government or not only the duty of state government, it is the duty of people as whole that we should try to save the water. Many times we just start the tap to wash water and leave the tap open and we leave the place. Small off. We are really concerned about the flowing water and lose finger about. In this way, people in colleges, schools, in the Gandhi Abhiyan, it is throughout our life, Bharatiya Janata Party water and solving water crisis. South is there, only throw into dustbin, I appeal on Andhra Pradesh. And we should keep up the wave in our country. Pro-incumbency has happened in Andhra Pradesh. This government, this party is literally thrown by the people. Janam Pradhan Mantri. He did not take leave for a single day. He did not allow his family to come to his home. He did not took his family for Videsh Yatras, foreign trips. That is Narendra Modi ji. And that is why the people of this country voted for Bharatiya Janata Party's Narendra Modi government for second time with the majority after 60 years in this country. A government which came to power with majority, it was people with the majority more than what it secured in last elections, consecutive second time. After 60 years since independence, it has happened in our country. that Narendra Modi ji was elected for the second time with majority more than what he got in last tenure. And this pro-incumbency you are going to observe in Haryana and Maharashtra. The recent poll surveys are showing going on 21st there is voting. Being a voter of Mumbai also, I will rush from here to Mumbai vote for our party to come to power in the Maharashtra state also. So this is pro-incumbency because of the delivery of the Bharatiya Janata Party governments. Why people are favoring BJP again and again? Because it is a principled party. The party doesn't believe you today that nobody knew the name of late Sushma Swaraj daughters. They know of Bansuri Swaraj. They could only know the name of Sushma Swaraj daughter when she was no more, and the daughter came in Shraddhanjali Sabha and Narendra Modi ji called her daughter by her name. Similarly about Arun Jaitley ji. Nobody knew the name of son of Arun Jaitley ji. Only after his sad demise in his Shraddhanjali Sabha, people came to know that name of Arun Jaitley ji's son is Rohan Jaitley. That is Bharatiya Janata Party. Even today, nobody can tell the name of Nitin Gadkari ji's sons. Nobody can tell the name of son of Lal Krishna Advani. I am quite confident that BJP leadership sitting here, they even don't know the name of son of Lal Krishna Advani ji. Because we don't work for our family. Our Prime Minister doesn't have his own family. Whenever he talks about family, he says that 130 crore Indians is his family. So we are against family Raj. We are against family politics. We are against Aviniti in politics. And also we are against casteism in politics, for which Mahatma Gandhi ji was deadly against the casteism in politics. Andhra Pradesh is suffering heavily from these three curses. One is Aviniti, one is family Raj, and the one is the casteism. Bharatiya Janata Party matra mein oka party, Aviniti party kaadu, Kula Tattva party kaadu, Kutumbam party kaadu. The Bharatiya Janata Party yokka ninadam. Bharatiya Janata Party yokka నినాదం ఇంత మాత్రమే. ఏమిటంటే మొదటిగా దేశం, రెండు అదిగా పార్టీ, చివరిగా నేను నా యొక్క. బరాబర్ కదా? నేషన్ ఫస్ట్, పార్టీ నెక్స్ట్, సెల్ఫ్ లాస్ట్. And that is why these are the principles of Mahatma Gandhi ji, these are the principles of Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay ji. And that is why whenever we got chance to rule this country, we could take hard decisions. Demonetization, GST, implementation of one nation, one constitution, abrogating of Article 370 and 35A. Such a strong decision to make this country one, only Narendra Modi ji and Amit Bhai Shah ji could take. Because of Bharatiya Janata Party. Bharatiya Janata Party has got clear-cut majority. And today, again I thank both the parties of Andhra Pradesh, YSRCP and TDP, for supporting the abrogation of Article 370 and 35A in Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. They have supported because they also wanted one nation, one constitution. It was questioned. It was not a question of party, it was not a question of any particular ideology, but it was a question of nation. And that is why both parties supported. We sought their support and they supported. But I would like to make clear to Andhra Pradesh people, it doesn't mean that there is any understanding between YSRCP and BJP or TDP and BJP. All parties are separate. And time and again I am telling and I repeat in Tirupati, with the blessings of Lord Venkateshwara, we are going to walk alone in this state. No need of Telugu Desam Party, no need of the corrupt Chandrababu Naidu, no need of Janasena. Bharatiya Janata Party will make its own road. People ask, the party which could not secure deposit in any of the constituency in assembly and parliament elections, party which could not get even 1% complete votes in this state, how you are going to contest in 2024? I would like to clear, I would like to make clear to the people of Andhra Pradesh that even the voters of Bharatiya Janata Party, fearing of TDP coming back to power, they also voted for YSRCP. And that is why whatever vote share YSRCP got this time, there is a big vote share of Bharatiya Janata Party, which we did not want, but people are clever. People did not want Babu to come back. People did not want this Aviniti party and directionless and hopeless party come back to power. And that is why even our voters, and the proof is, as soon as we started our membership campaigning, the party which got 2,80,000 votes in parliament and assembly elections, our membership reached 8 lakhs in this state, 8 lakhs. And that membership is online membership, verified with OTP, verified with call center. And if you count the family members' votes, because from one member only one person got the membership, they could have made, but usually they make one person member. If you add the family members, then it is already, it has crossed 15 to 17 lakhs in this state. And our membership campaigning is not stopped. Our membership campaigning is getting momentum. It is going ahead. It is marching ahead. Regularly, there are joinings from Telugu Desam Party. Regularly, there are joinings from Janasena. And surprisingly, regularly, there are joinings from YSRCP also. And specifically, the minority, the women, the youth, those who were in the YSRCP party, they are joining Bharatiya Janata Party. I don't want to criticize present government because it is very new, it has got the mandate of the people and only 6 months you can, it is very early to comment. But there are certain things which this government should do. Previously, Narendra Modi ji declared 6,000 rupees per year for every raitu, that is farmer, Kisan Sanman Nidhi. YSRCP assured during elections that we will give 18,000 more, or including 6,000, they will give total 18,500. They declared
before
election, they declared. But actually after that they named YSR Raitu Bharosa. But then they understood that same thing Chandrababu Naidu also committed mistake. Pacha Rengu Vesi, Chandranna sticker Anticharu, Chandranna Bima, Chandranna Bata, Chandranna Ye Illu. Lekin sab diya Modi ji ne, inhone sirf pacha rang lagaya, peela rang laga kar sticker lagaya. Janta ko achha nahi laga. Isliye YSR Congress bhi samajh gayi, and then they added the name PPM Kisan in that name. Well, it is good that they appreciated that the money is coming from center, but the money committed by them, they are not giving complete, whatever may be their problem, but they should fulfill the promise what they have given to people. Secondly, our Ayushman Bharat scheme was not properly implemented during TDP. Now there are certain schemes about the health issues and the patients. This government is coming. But people should know it is part of Ayushman Bharat Narendra Modi ji's central government schemes. Similarly, for economically backward class, first time in this country, the bold decision was taken by Narendra Modi ji without disturbing any of the reservations present in the reservations. Only economically backward people could get reservation. Means the economically backward, whether scheduled caste, scheduled tribe, minorities, OBCs, Brahmins.